Okay, now good evening. I'm doing this short video for us to interact a bit, especially with math. And today we are going to talk about comparing fractions. And when we talk about comparing fractions, already we've talked about fractions. And I described fractions to you as a part of a whole. And when we say a part of a whole, this is what we mean by a part of a whole. So now you realize that, for example, this one you see here is a whole. It has not been divided into any section or any part. So this is a whole. So it is considered as one. So when it has not been divided into any parts, it is what? One. That is what we call a whole number or a whole object. So that is one. Now, the second fraction is called half. Why do you call it half? Because it has been divided into two equal parts. Realize that we have it two equal parts. Then the next one is what we call quarter. This is quarter. Quarter in the sense that you realize that this one was divided into two equal parts. When you divide half into two, another two equal parts, this way you get quarter. So when half is divided again into two, we get quarter. That's 1/4. What it simply means is that we have a whole object like a mango. And now we have divided a mango into four equal part, one, two, three, four. And you are being asked to take one or shade one or just give one to someone. So the one that you're taking out of the four sections gives you a quarter. That is 1/4. And the rest goes on and on and on like that. So here you realize that this is 3/4 because we have shaded three and we've left one. But how many sections are there? There are four sections. One, two, three, four. I hope you understand. The same applies to this one. This is called one whole, like I told you. One half. Three thirds. Three thirds. That means that it has been divided into three, and we have taken all the three. And then this one is what? One fourth or quarter. Another name for quarter is 1/4. Now let's proceed. Okay, so before we can compare fractions, like our topic is, now, well, before you can compare a fraction, you need to look at this animal. This animal is called a crocodile. Now let's look at the jaws of the crocodile. This is the jaw. Is the jaw of a crocodile. Have you seen it? Okay, now, have you seen how open it is? Now, that is the same description of our sign that we are going to use. The crocodile wants big meat. So, whenever it sees a very big meat, it tries to eat it up. Okay, good. So, wherever there is what? A bigger fraction, we open the mouth of the crocodile to eat it up. So like this one, this sign, it shows the mouth of a crocodile. Have you seen it? So it opens up to any big meat that it sees. This one. Okay. So for example, if A is bigger than B, it means that it is going to open its mouth to the A because the A is the bigger one and the B is what, the smaller one. So wherever you see a bigger number, open the mouth of the crocodile to it. As simple as that. Now let's look at it. So this sign gives you greater than this one. And I'll tell you why it is greater than. It is greater than because, let me simply even put it this way. It is greater than because look.